I don't know how it started, I suppose it was about the 10th grade. I'd never bought much music, I just listened to whatever was played. But there was classic rock there on the radio, and it was blowing my mind. And it was all the records no one wanted now, so they were easy to find. So I started getting LPs, they only cost a little, and these LPs were all the ones I needed from the 60s, with psychedelic art on all the great sleeves, much cooler and much cheaper than the CDs, and that's the way I caught the disease. I caught the disease for LPs. There wasn't any internet, a lot of times you just took a shot. Pretty soon you figured out which records would be awesome or not. If the year was from the 60s, it was probably good bang for your buck. If the year was from the 80s, it was guaranteed to totally suck. I started learning about the LPs, at that time education just cost low fees. $3 for this Dylan record, oh yes please, and the cream and Rolling Stones and Arlo Guthrie's. A giant treasure trove was all for pennies, and that's the way I caught the disease. I caught the disease for LPs. By 1994, I had completed all my Zeppelin and Floyd.
Zeppelin and Floyd.
I had all the early traffic, but their later stuff just made me annoyed.
Made me annoyed.
You realize that the radio just scratches at the top of the dirt.
Top of the dirt.
When $4 can buy you Crown of Creation with a lyric insert. So I had a lot of LPs. My friends were mostly clueless, it was just me in an ocean of cheap vinyl like a black sea. I hardly had an income, but it was easy. An awesome world awaited with a cheap key. And sometimes in the garbage they were just free. And that's the way I caught the disease. I caught the disease for LPs. And then the 90s ended and I wasn't no teenager no more. But I started getting shakes if I was passing any used record store.
Record store.
I got the finger muscles you develop when you flip through a stack.
Flip through a stack.
Crate digging for the cheap and obscure, and there was no turning back. A total junkie for the LPs, and nothing in the world was gonna help me. You'd see me quit no sooner than see hell freeze. And there was nothing like the thrill of getting lucky. I'd be lying 5 feet to the breeze. Cause the world was still awash in LPs. And I still had the disease for LPs. Nowadays that stuff is so expensive I don't bother to try. Everything's reissued and plus everything is priced really high. The field is overcrowded, it's impossible to get a good fix. So I walk right past the records, and I flip through all the used compact discs. Yeah, nowadays it's mostly CDs. No one wants to keep them, so there's plenty. Folk and punk and private press and rap and indie. Bonus tracks and liner notes are just empty. As long as I can still make a good discovery, I've still got that music hunger disease. That disease that I got from LPs. When they were dirt cheap.